Hello everyone, this is Siddiqur Rahman and welcome to the fourth continuation of the fifth lecture of the second week. So let's start. By the end of this lecture, you guys will be able to convert binary to hexadecimal number. So let's move into the next slide. This slide represents the overall scenario of this lecture, and as we have seen from this slide, there is plenty of things we may learn from this lecture, such as conversion of binary to hexadecimal, example of indirect method, binary to hexadecimal conversion table, example of direct method, and homework, and that's it. And let's move into the next slide. From this slide, we may learn the overview of binary to hexadecimal. So let's begin. Hexadecimal number system provides convenient way of converting large binary numbers into more compact and smaller groups. There are various ways to convert a binary number into hexadecimal number. You can convert using direct methods or indirect methods. First, you need to convert a binary number into other base system, such as decimal or into octal. Then you need to convert it into hexadecimal number. So let's move into the next slide. This slide represent a mathematical problem about the conversion, which is binary to hexadecimal, and this problem is solved by a method and which is named as indirect method. So let's begin with the question. What is 1101010 binary number in the hexadecimal number? So this problem is solved by the two part. And in this slide, we get an idea about the first part, and in the next slide, we get the idea about the second part. So let's start with the solution and the first part. So first part and first step, convert the provided binary number into the equivalent decimal number. We already do that in our second week lecture. So I must say that you don't have any problem regarding this issue. So let's start. 1101002, which is equivalent to 1 into 2 to the power 6 plus 1 into 2 to the power 5 plus 0 into 2 to the power 4 plus 1 into 2 to the power 3 plus 0 into 2 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 0 into 2 to the power 0. And we get, after the multiplication, 64 plus 32 plus 0 plus 8 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0, which is given to us 106 decimal number, which is equivalent decimal number of the given binary number. So let's move into the next part and also next slide. And this slide represents the second part of the first problem. So let's start with the solution. Second part and second step, convert the found or founded decimal number into the equivalent hexadecimal number. Well, we got 106 and it is the equivalent decimal number of the given binary number. So we can write 106 base 10 is equals to 6 into 16 to the power 1 plus 10 into 16 to the power 0. And which is equivalent to 6A, and which is equivalent hexadecimal number of the given binary number. So that's all from the problem solution. So let's move into the next slide. This slide represents a conversion table and the conversion in between binary to hexadecimal. If we choose a number from the table, say 1010, and if we convert this binary number into hexadecimal, then we get the alphabet A, and which is equivalent to 10. Well, if we choose another number from the table, such as 0111, and if we convert this binary number into hexadecimal, then we get 7. So let's move into the next slide. And this slide represents another example of the conversion. And the conversion belongs binary to hexadecimal. So let's start with the question. What is 1010101010001 binary number in hexadecimal. And in this example, we are using direct method to solve this problem. So let's start with the solution. Therefore, convert the provided binary number into the equivalent hexadecimal number. As we already know from the previous slide, or we have already known that hexadecimal number is a 4-bit number, 4-bit consists of 4 bits, so that's why we can group our given binary number to convert the hexadecimal number. So let's start. So if you see the first line of the solution, then you can find that 1001 from the right. I start from the right, so you can understand 1001 0110 1010 and lastly 1. And in here you see the most left, there is only one number, which is 1. And for grouping, or for making new, for making a group, we can add 3 zeros beside the most left number of 1, and which is the indication of the in figure. You can see the right portion of the slide, a figure is represented. So I hope you understand. There is no problem to understand. So let's start, and we get we add 3 zeros beside the MSB 1. So there is 4 groups now, which is 1 from the right. From the right, I read from the right side, I read 1010 0101 1010 and 1000. And the equivalent hexadecimal number of 0001 is 1. The equivalent hexadecimal number of 0101 is 5. The equivalent hexadecimal number of 0110 is 6, and the next one is 9. And we get the equivalent hexadecimal number is 1569 of the given binary number. So this is the solution of this problem. So let's move into the next slide. This slide represents some of the examples for you guys to practice at your home by your own. So let's move into the next slide. In the next lecture, you guys will learn how to convert hexadecimal number into binary number. Next. That's all for this lecture, and thank you for your attention, and see you guys in the next lecture. Thank you.